Ashraf, looks like you're going to lose your job soon. In the meantime, let's look at 7 app ideas you can start building today using AI. This video has 3 goals. The first is to educate. Before committing to creating a product or starting a business with AI at its core, there are a few things to have clarity on. The second is to focus. People treating AI like a shiny new toy with endless possibilities, but it's been around forever. Be careful not to end up the victim of a trend with some timeless business principles to guide decision making. And the third is to inspire. Based on our understanding of AI and what makes businesses profitable, we'll look at a few ideas that could work. But I know why all of you click on this video. You want to see if any of my ideas are worth trying. So let's go to part 3 first. 7 app ideas that leverage AI and I think have the potential to make money. Using AI to produce authentic exam practice questions. I said produce, not predict actual questions. That's impossible. And even if you could do it, don't do it. Cheating is bad. Once an AI model has analyzed enough questions on a particular topic in a certain format, it will be able to generate endless new questions with slight variations. And because it will also be trained in the current syllabus, the variations will be restricted to themes, topics that will be tested. You can leverage OpenAI's AI model's ability to understand English instructions to allow users to specify what type of questions they would like to attempt. They can specify exam parts, topics, even difficulty levels. This isn't new. Cambridge is already using AI to mark their lingua skill exams, including written and spoken papers. That's just one example, a proof of concept, if you will. There are a billion exams out there delivered in English. Find one with a decent demand and train your AI model to specialize in producing novel questions for it. Also, by training it on existing marking schemes, it can accurately grade answers and provide justifications to its scores. In other words, it provides real-time feedback to learners so that they know how to improve. An app like this would make physical and digital exercise books irrelevant. Anyone who wants to score well in an exam will find your app more useful because with a traditional learning management system, you've still got a set number of questions. Meanwhile, your app can produce an unlimited number. Asian parents all over the world will love you. Now their kids can keep studying forever. Using AI to create a test partner for speaking test. The first entry focused more on writing, reading and listening tasks. But a lot of language papers have speaking tests. Speaking is logistically the hardest skill to practice because you need a speaking partner. Partner that can listen to you and reply and vice versa. Together, you have what it's called a conversation. When it comes to exams, you can't just talk about whatever you want. The task will test specific speaking skills, fluency, use of discourse markers, ability to correct yourself, staying on topic, a whole bunch of other stuff. For this reason, you can't just practice with your mom, but I can. I'm definitely firing Ashraf. Anyways, you need a partner familiar with the exam format who can do deliberate practice with you. If you are a working adult or you live in a certain part of the world, it can be very difficult to find someone that fits that profile. But who says it needs to be someone? I'm specifically thinking of ChatGPT here. This OpenAI model is specifically trained to understand language input and produce human-like replies. I'm thinking combine it with a simple speech-to-text translator and train the AI model on exam tasks, correct responses, and topical vocabulary. You got yourself a speaking partner. So now, an exam candidate can use your app as their speaking partner. The AI doesn't just generate appropriate responses, it understands the exam task that is being done and it wants to complete it. Think of it as the Siri of speaking exams. IELTS will never be the same again. Using AI to design funky looking consumer products. For the right price, people have never been able to resist weird ass designs. Go into any niche and you'll see the same thing. Motorcycle helmets, hoodies, guitars, jewelry. My personal suggestion for something design focused, tattoo design generator. This already exists, but one, they don't look very good, and two, they are pretty general. You want to dive deep into a particular niche, maybe specialize in generating cool geometric sleeves or portraits of celebrities making various expressions. Michael Jackson dancing, Michael Jackson eating breakfast. I don't know, I like Michael Jackson. To really take it to the next level, have your app be able to detect body parts and map designs to them. This way, user can upload photos of themselves and they can actually test a design to see if they like how it looks on them. Whatever you choose to specialize in, your Dall-E or Stable Diffusion model will have to be trained on a data set comprising tons and tons of pictures of that subject matter, as well as anything related that you might want to combine. This is something that both normal users would be interested in, but you really want to aim for tattoo artists who will be willing to pay for high quality designs that they can sell for a profit. Using AI to transcribe and translate audio simultaneously. Even up until now, companies that do subtitling work for TV still need humans, because AI is not quite as reliable when it comes to detecting more subtle parts of spoken language. It's pretty much impossible to teach AI how to detect something like sarcasm. Even people have trouble detecting sarcasm. And by people, I mean my girlfriend. However, it's definitely possible for AI to detect tone, context, and chunks of meanings like phrases and proverbs. Here's a really stupid example. Chicken fingers. Individually, they have separate meanings, but combine them into chicken fingers and you have what's known in English as compound noun. You can definitely train AI to understand multiple languages to the point that it can accurately translate chunks of meaning across them all. One case study you can use is Papago. They are pretty much the go-to for Korean English translation, and their AI model learns from its mistakes to provide better translations next time. As far as I know, there isn't yet anything as good as Papago that works as a transcriber, meaning the transcribing and super accurate translation occurs at the same time. In fact, you could even offer multiple translations in one go. Imagine being able to play an audio or video track and the AI transcribes it, then immediately translates it into X number of target languages. Translation companies would kill to have a software like this. Now their human staff can spend their time focusing on that last 5%, meaning significantly faster output. Hey, like you, I'm excited to see where the explosion of AI will take us. I'm planning to dive deeper into AI and mobile apps, so subscribe for more content like this. Using AI to simplify complex legal documents. If you've ever had to read a legal document, my condolences. Those things are confusing, long-winded, and just plain long. Sometimes you don't have a choice. You need to understand it. For example, you might need to fully understand a contract before signing it. You might need to reply to a letter from an attorney about a legal issue. What people normally do is show the document to a lawyer and get them to explain what the hell it's saying. They can also have the lawyer draft a reply. The main issue here is cost. Lawyers are not cheap, but AI is. OpenAI's AI model can already be trained to summarize entire books into bullet points. It can also write custom emails. I think you can see where I'm going with this. By training AI on present laws of a certain country, you can produce an app that can analyze legal documents and summarize them in simple, everyday language for its users. You can even get it to draft replies or contracts based on what it advises you to do. It could be trained to highlight any potentially one-sided terms. Basically, it reads the fine print for you and says, "Hey, the wording in this part sounds a bit worrying. You should take a closer look." I think this is an especially lucrative idea because, one, it's going to be hard to do. And number two, the legal profession in many countries is still very much old-fashioned because it's dominated by an older generation. But younger people will need legal services just as much, and you would be in the perfect position to capture this demographic. If you don't have a background in law yourself, you need to partner with someone who does. They can provide expert input and lend credibility when you go to market. Also, keep in mind that different countries may have different requirements for those who can and cannot legally offer services like this. Like I said, it's a good idea, but lawyer up. Using AI to rapidly create criminal sketches. When a crime happens and you go to the police station, they've got a sketch artist that draws a sketch of the suspect based on eyewitness descriptions. Thing is, depending on how much time elapses between witnessing a crime and speaking to the sketch artist, a lot of details can be forgotten, especially when it's a very traumatic experience. Even worse, it's possible our brain creates false memories and the description is now completely off. I think there's a huge potential for an app that can create a realistic sketch, or even better, a color photograph of a perpetrator based on key variables like skin tone, tattoos, hairstyle, and whatever else a police sketch artist would ask. It can then make adjustments to the photo based on further input. Make the gaps between the eyebrows bigger, make the nostrils smaller, make one eye squint a little, exactly what you would say to a sketch artist. Only now, the memory is still fresh and you have the best chance of remembering accurately. In fact, as we were working on this script, I read about a very recent attempt at creating this. It's still in closed testing, so I have no idea how good it is, but the developers were going to reach out to the police department for assistance. Using AI to generate Aquascape suggestions. This piggybacks off of Peter Level's awesome AI-powered interior AI. The app lets you upload an image of a room, input what kind of living space you would like to turn it into, and then it creates visual suggestions on how you could decorate the space. It's been extremely successful, generating hundreds of thousands of dollars in revenue. I have an idea that leverages identical AI functions, but for a niche yet still profitable industry, aquascaping. Aquascaping is like gardening underwater. The goal is to decorate your aquarium with plants, rocks, and wood in an aesthetically pleasing way. Many of you will be surprised this is even a thing. You'll be even more surprised to hear that annually, it is $100 million to $1 billion industry depending on sources. There are tons of international aquascaping competitions that receive entries from literally all over the world, namely the annual Aquatic Gardeners Association Aquascaping Contest. As you can see, just like with interior design, there are different themes different people go for. For example, the biotope category is all about creating scapes that resemble nature. The Dutch style focuses on arranging plants in tight formation like a botanical garden. This app would be identical to interior AI, but instead of being trained to create bathroom designs, you're going to train it on tons and tons of beautiful underwater scapes so it can help hobbyists think up new designs for their tanks. I hope you can see that it doesn't have to be aquascaping. Any hobby or niche that requires some sort of creative design that's derivative of any existing work is up for grabs here. Some basic terminology for newbies: dataset and training AI. There are tons of AI models out there. OpenAI is just the most well-known. As it is, OpenAI has a few different AI models, each specializing in something a little different. ChatGPT is the most famous, specializing in understanding input and generating responses in natural language. But ChatGPT itself is more like a line of different models. Depending on what you want to use AI for, you may not need the most advanced or expensive model. As they are, these models have pretty broad application, which should be narrowed down for your specific use case. Think of a model as a fresh graduate. They have general skills, but if you want a star performer, you need to teach them about your business and industry. We do that by training AI models with custom datasets. Datasets here mean specific, accurate information in sufficient quantities that match whatever output you want the AI model to produce. Time to look at what makes a business idea worthwhile. This is best answered by looking at actual successful businesses that leverage AI. Copy AI, Reply AI, Quick Chat, Lensa. Like all other businesses, AI or not, they have two things in common. Specificity: the businesses themselves are very clear about their value proposition, which means users know what they can expect. All of them have taken a particular AI model, then customized it to fit their customers' use case. Next, demand. That use case has to have sufficient demand. There's no point specifying your product for a use case that no one will pay for. What normally happens is you want to do something and it's unnecessarily complicated given available technology. That's your eureka moment, because chances are you've discovered a market gap. That's the normal way. That's also the batshit crazy way, the Peter Levels way. You don't wait for the gap to come to you, you go to the gap. This man launched startup after startup after startup, and by his own admission, only 4 out of over 70 projects were a success, which is about a 6% success rate. But his 6% has made him a billionaire. So, specificity and demand. And because we're talking about software development, remember the rest of your app. You're developing an AI-powered app. You need to make sure this part is up to a standard that delivers a user experience people will be willing to pay for. Often, an app like that will cost money and time to develop. Even after development, if you want a commercial-grade app that keeps up with changes to a technology stack, there will be maintenance fees. If the term app maintenance cost is new to you, I mean no disrespect, but if you are serious about pursuing this, sit down with a developer. They may point out how your idea isn't practical or there's already something like that. That's fine, by the way. It's just good to know the competition. If possible, I strongly advise you to find someone with a technical background to guide you. It would be a shame if your idea didn't meet its full potential because of poor technical execution. But I get it if you'd rather try it solo. You want to keep costs low and work in a low-risk environment. In that case, I'll recommend you watch my video on no-code app builders where I share my thoughts on which no-code platform is the best choice according to your goals. What you'll definitely want is a no-code platform where you can easily integrate OpenAI's API or any AI model's API for that matter. So you too can put AI at the end of your app's name and ride the hype train. AI is super exciting, and honestly, I'm just happy I can fire my scriptwriter. I wonder who else I can fire. Maybe myself? Wait, can I do that? Can a founder fire himself? That's just resigning, isn't it? Hope you find this video has given you some ideas. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the no-code app builder video.